morning. Presentation started.
I, Srishti Sangar, and I, Babu Vila, welcome you all, respected panel members and all dear student managers. We are from River Kaveri, and we will be presenting our induction presentation for the batch 2019. So before starting the journey, the product which you are going to talk about is a very well-known brand. So I'll play an audio clip, so I'd like the audience to identify the product which you are going to talk about. Oh, it's already been shown. But say if you like to play the audio clip. The contents which we will highlight today are the introduction, the ban of Maggi, the company's response to the ban, the revival of the Maggi brand, marketing strategies after revival, and then finally the conclusion. So the person who has been depicted on the slide is Julius Maggi. He introduced a Maggi brand in 1886 in Switzerland. He firstly invented a powder pea and bean soup, so which was aimed as being preparing a healthy food for the aiming at the working women who worked in the factories who didn't have time to prepare the food for their family. Then in 1947, Nestle acquired the Maggi brand. Then Nestle India Limited launched a Maggi brand in 1982, Maggi noodles was launched in 1982.
Maggi in India. Maggi in India was the first instant noodle produced by Nestle India Limited, NIL, in which in 1982, the first noodle it used were 2 months. But unfortunately, in 1997, the Maggi brand experienced a dip. Reason being, they could not understand what the Indian crowd wanted as a eating material. That is when in 1999 they started bringing back their original Maggi masala with the instant noodle concept, and that is when they again experienced a hype. In 2001, Maggi became the largest shareholder in the instant noodles market. By 2005 to 2009, Maggi, in order to remain a fresh brand, introduced various other products like Atta Maggi in order to always remain in top of its competitors. Then, although Maggi was not always involved in Bollywood fiasco, they took a risk in order to gain again the popularity by making Amitabh Bachchan as their brand ambassador, and we all have witnessed various Amitabh Bachchan sentimental ads as Maggi ads in our day-to-day life. That is when we saw that Maggi brand instant noodles is regaining and it is prospering, various other products are also released. Like the Maggi sauce, the Maggi pasta, Maggi magic cubes, which are form of cubes of Maggi masala only.
So the next slide is ban of Maggi. Sanjay Singh, the food inspector of Uttar Pradesh Food and Drug Administration, took a random read in which he spotted on the label which was present on the Maggi packet that no added MSG. He claimed that there has been some amount of MSG added into it. So the sample which was sent to the Gorakhpur test laboratories, and there it was found that yes, it is the LABG present inside it. Then again, after this, the samples were again taken and then sent to the central laboratory, Kolkata, in June 2014. After a year of it, in April 2015, the result came out of that test that yes, there was an MSG content in it. MSG stands for monosodium glutamate. So there is MSG content in it, and we also provided that there was 17.2 parts per million LAB content, the lead content into it. That is 1,000 times more than the actual content which the NIL had claimed. Then after that, when this test had been launched, the news came to the media in which that was written that nationwide scare was witnessed at that time because people were totally against it. Then in June, Nestle did not react to it because they didn't call that it will be a very the steps which will it will affect them, so they didn't react well about it. They had a press conference on 1st of June saying that they have tested the 125 million units of Maggi and there is no such content of MSG found through to it. In full on 5th of June, okay. FSSAI, that is Food Standards and Food Safety Authority of India, they ordered National India Limited to review the Maggi packages from the retailer. They withdrew all the 9 variants of the Maggi and then they termed it as hazardous and unfit for the human consumption. In 2015, Maggi
loss in his 17 years of existence. Then a new chief was assigned at NIL, that is the Nestle India Limited, named Suresh Narayanan, who claimed that in spite of this ban of our famous product Maggi, we will make sure that it is restocked in the retailers' market. Although Maggi was banned, they did not stop. They thought to invest more on the other products Maggi had introduced into the market, like the sauce or the pasta or anything. And that is when they thought to invest more in it so that the loss they are making could be replaced. But in the Maggi, when Maggi was bought back from the retail stores and everything, beyond 30,000 metric tons of Maggi was destroyed. 20 crores were paid to the cement companies to destroy and burn Maggi. And the Nestle Indian Limited experienced 650 crore loss.
So during the bad time, there were many competitors which arrived and they emerged with that party time. So there were some like potentially other noodles, chiffon noodles, Yippee had the most of the share of the market during that period of time. The earlier it was, this market share was 15%, but during the ban of Maggi, it rose to 22%. And so on the chips share, market share in the instant noodle segment was 1.9%. Nor had a share of 2%, Patanjali had a share of 1.2%, and during the time Maggi was withdrawn back from the market, so it had 0% market share.
Maggi was unable to resist the fact that it had been banned. So, when it was banned, a few weeks later, Maggi decided to reconduct the test. In reconducting the test, they approached the High Court, in which they were rejected, but then they approached the Supreme Court, which gave them three committees in order to take 13 packets each, which were to be tested. The NABL, which is an organization appointed by the government, was given the task to again test the Maggi and its contents. As I said, Maggi was able to resist the pandemic, although claiming MSG-free and lead levels are low, would be named or classified as a product which is unfit or hazardous. That is when they got the clearance that in fact it is not hazardous and it will not be contagious in any consumption, and hence the revival started taking place. In order to revive themselves, they took the auspicious occasion of Diwali. But they did not even come to the retail stores first. They decided to target the e-commerce. That is when they contacted Snappy and they came up with the Tinky Deal logo, in which they had a Snappy box, which 12 to 13 packets each, in which they welcome back Maggi was the tagline they gave.
So the market share of Maggi in India, before the ban, Maggi captured as the top of the Maggi instant noodle segment. It has captured around 75% of the total market share in India. During the ban, Maggi was totally being swept from the market. In 2016, after the ban was removed, Maggi was back with 41.6% share in the instant noodle segment. Now today in 2019, it captured around 60% share in the instant noodle segment.
Maggi was already back in the market, but strategizing to reach to the position it was before was vital. That is why the campaign #BBC2 was started. For the same, we have a video.
रात को सोनू जब दबे पाव आकर मैगी बनाता था, मुझे पता होता था। माँ के कान से कभी झुकती कोई आहट, पर उसे करने देती थी। बच्चों को थोड़ा तो स्पेस देना चाहिए, और फिर तसल्ली रहती थी कि भूखे पेट तो नहीं सो रहा है ना। पर जब मैगी पे सवाल उठी तो मुझे लगा क्या कुछ गलत था कि सोने दे रही थी उसे, वो भी इतने सालों से। आज सुना हर टेस्ट में यही निकला है, सब ठीक है हमारी मैगी मैगी ऐसे लग रहा है मैं भी पास हो गई।
एंड देन द मैगी वाज टारगेटेड विद इंडिविजुअल हाउसहोल्ड्स टू रीगेन देयर ट्रस्ट दे हैड.
The steps which he has undertaken was we issued to half-staffers that because he had decided to